Sunsama is one of the coolest apps out there. Does it really get much better than this?
Nah, it doesn't.
But what if we recreated the way that Sunsama looked? Like this, inside of Notion. We're talking including channels here. Let's talk about that. In order for this to happen, we're going to need to make a board database. So we do /board and then press new database right here. And first and foremost, what we're going to have to do is change this status. Select property to be called day of week, and then quickly change all of these to the proper days of the week, Sunday through Saturday. So once you've put them in their proper order in here, you are going to go to this section and go to the grouping by day of the week, get rid of the no day of the week and order them properly here. And what you can do as well is then go to the three dots and go to the board layout and change the cart size to small. So that way you have a better view of just everything being in one line here. And then in order to break this up, what we're going to want to do is just get a block here and another block here. And you're going to want to break this up so that you have this first text section right here where it's mainly to the left, just enough for a mention. And then you're going to quickly go into the daily planner section, then create another property that we can call channel. So this, for example, would be like in Sunsama, how we have these multiple channels. So we're going to have one that is called, for these purposes, Rise Productive, as that is my brand. And then, for example, another one could be called Work and then Life. What we're going to do is put a extra page towards the bottom here and just call this the backend or something to that effect. And then what we're going to do is we go to properties and have the channel one show here. So for example, this has Rise Productive, Work, and Life on all of these for this main page. And this is going to be the all section that we're going to have. So we're going to do copy the link to this board here and then make a new page. We're going to call it all. And then we can pretty much make the same setup here where we create a linked view of this board. Then we do something similar here. We break it up and drag this to the left. The goal here is essentially we're going to make a synced block of everything. So here we then can take the three dots from this page and do a mention page here or a link to page. You can even put a hashtag over here if you want to make it similar to what Sunsama actually had. Then I'm going to copy this and go back to where the Sunsama is, paste this block here. And then all that we're going to do is we're going to go into the back end. We're going to duplicate this. Then what we're going to do is tweak this setup a little bit more. I'm going to do another bit of text here and then put another column in here. Make sure there's enough space for the all to show. And just like in Sunsama, there's about a 4 or 5 day view here. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days. So we can add a little bit more if we would like here to like the Sunday area or Saturday area, or we can make it like this. So then over here, so we'd have a capture inbox. So we go capture inbox by putting like an H2 or something. Capture inbox. Then we can put this name here if we want to hide this. And then we could take this database, copy the link, paste it in here. What we're going to do is change this to a list view and then add a property that's a checkbox. And then if we want to delete this assign or keep it, it's up to you, but I'm going to delete it personally. And then on these three dots, we're going to show this status. We're going to make sure that this is actually a select. And then moving forward with this, we can change the property layout to show the status here. And then from a filtering perspective, all we need to do is make it so that the filter has status unchecked. And then we can do a merge into an advanced filter just to make it easier on ourselves. It's where status is unchecked. And then I'm going to add a filter group and put or where, and then we're going to actually have to add a new property and do created time just to make it easier on ourselves really quick. And then furthering with this filter to where day of week is empty. So then we can sort these by created time so that like the new ones would be on the bottom there or the top, whichever one you prefer. So the sort there would be ascending or descending based on your preference. Then we press save for everybody. Whenever a task would come up, what we'd do is we'd drag this over to this section to whichever day of the week we want. And in order to make it separated with these different options by channel, what we could do is go back into the backend, duplicate this, change it 2, whatever the name of one of yours is. So we got Rise Productive, Work, and Life. So all I'm going to do is put Rise Productive and then filter this to where the channel is Rise Productive and then save this. Then we can copy the link to this page, go into the synced block, paste this link to page, drop this guy in here. And then if we want to extend this view at all, we can go here and tweak this a little bit to make the capture inbox a little smaller and this section a little bigger. And then all we got to do is do this a couple times. So then in the back end, we just create the same amount of ones as we have with the amount of select properties we have for the different channels. So we can make this one work, filter this to the channel being work on the select, work on the select only, copy link, paste a link to page in here, then go back to this one, filter it to life only, call this page life, copy the three dots, paste this in here, and then you'd be able to shuffle through all of these and only see the life ones if you're in the life page, the work ones if you're on the work page, etc. And then since it is Notion, what you could do is have a notes database be paired with this, or whenever new integrations are put out there, you can have things showcasing that. Or if you have a calendar database, what you could do is create a setup where you then could go here. And if you want to change the back end, it was just my way to get things to work. You want to change it so that this whole database is actually here. Just delete this and make it so that in reality, you can name this home or Sunsama, whatever you want to do. And then you can have all of your different databases within here, whether it's in a page or in a toggle block. You can even turn this into a page to make it easier. You could make things like a calendar page, like a notes calendar or something like that. Turn this into a page really easily. Copy the link to the view. And then all you'd have to do would be go into one of these and like drop this calendar here and then have a similar filter setup where you just set up the channel property. And then each one that you cycle through, it would change the filter that it has there. And then for any future integrations, all you'd have to do is add extra views and list views. Say they make sync databases that you could easily then drag over to this daily planner, or put another section over here to show anything that you'd want to then input onto your daily planner section here. It's a little backwards, but I figured maybe you'd like this. And I figured that you would like this video on how to improve your Notion even more.